Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our next lunchtime recital here at St. James in Liberty. Welcome to all of you that are watching online via our Facebook live stream page. I want to welcome and introduce Dr. Amity Bryson. She's our soprano today. She's a professor of voice and director of music and choral studies and everything at Avila University. So we are thankful that you're here, and without further ado, here we go.
Wonderful gift. And then my second thought was, I only want to sing songs that I love. And so these are just some of my greatest hits, favorites, just fun things to come back to and remember. And so this is a set of four English pieces. Norman Della Gioia, Samuel Barber, John Duke, some of my favorites, but also the poets. We have Elizabeth Barrett Browning, James Agee, and no one sets Shakespeare like Amy.
I love you.
So this next set is three little Mozart art songs, and every time I think of Mozart, I just imagine that he wrote these at the age of 13, and we should all be jealous and, you know, frown on Mozart because he can do things none of the rest of us can. And yet, it's these three pieces were actually written right around his 30s. They were snuck in between Don Giovanni and Le Nozze, and so he was working on these huge, large works, and they really are little mini caricatures. The first is Das Veilchen, and I have to share, I got the wonderful honor at Christmas of putting my nephew to bed, 16, 18 months old, and my brother said, the system is, we read a few books and then we sing a few songs, and by the way, the only song I ever sing him is the Mizzou fight song from beginning to end. And so, sweet little Connor, and I read books, and then it became time for songs, and yeah, I'm not singing a fight song, I'm sorry. And so I'm singing Das Veilchen, Karl mio ben, the sweet little baby boy, loved the French, loved the Italian, loved the German, this child shall do great things. And so Das Veilchen is just this lovely story of a violet, and the personification of just living life, and everything is going fine, and then this beautiful maiden comes. And oh, if she would only pluck me and crush me to her chest, and I could die there in happiness. But no, the young woman doesn't see the violet, she simply steps on the violet. And the violet says, oh, but I will still die happy, because I died under her foot. And then the next piece I will sing for you is longest title of an art song of all time. Als Luise die Briefe ihres ungetreuen Liebhabers verbrannte. When Louise burned the letters of her unfaithful lover. And if this is not a tiny little Mozart aria, I don't know what is. But it's one of the rare pieces that Mozart set from a female poet, Gabrielle von Bauernberg. And so she's angry, and you'll be able to tell. And then the final piece, I'll take a little minute and share a little more about the text as we get there.
Feuerchen auf der Wiese steht, gebannt mit Zähnen und Hand. Es war ein
Mozart setting is Abendempfindung an Laura. And ihr danket, you heard in the Aus Louise, ihr is the not formal personal in German. German was my worst language, but I know that there's proper use and informal use, and it is so beautiful within the text of Abendempfindung when it changes from the ihr, the non-formal everybody. Obviously there was not a personal relationship in Aus Louise, but in Abendempfindung there's a moment where Mozart turns to the du bist, you, and it's that beloved, and just from the conjugation of the word, it allows us to know that this is a beautiful relationship, and it is ending only because one member is passing away. It is evening. The sun has gone down, and the moon is shining silver. Life's loveliest hours disappear too and fly by like a dance. The theater of life does not last, and the curtain rolls down. Our play is over. The tears of a friend are already flowing on our grave. Like a gentle breeze blowing from the west, I sense a quiet foreboding that soon I shall end this pilgrimage of life and fly into the land of rest. If you weep at my grave, my friends, and mourn over my ashes, I shall appear to you and breathe a breath of heaven upon you. If thou, too, weepest but a teardrop for me and pickest a violet upon my grave, look gently down on me. Grant me a tear, do not be ashamed to consecrate it to me. It will be the loveliest pearl in my diadem.
Oh,
piece always reminds me of my grandparents, so I always count it a success when I make it from beginning to end. I'm going to turn to a set of three tiny English pieces from Mark Blitzstein, who is an interesting character that I think a lot of us don't know because of his circumstances. He became famous when he wrote the musical The Cradle Will Rock, which was very much based on social justice and the injustices within the workforce. And Orson Welles directed that piece, and there was great drama because they shut him down in one theater because it was seen as controversial, and they rolled a piano down the street and did it anyway, and all of the actors with their equity cards could have been fired on the spot for performing. So no one walked on stage. The singers simply stood in the house and sang. Blitzstein was ready to perform it alone. And when the first piece came up and the soprano stood and sang from the house, it's just, I can only imagine how dramatic and heartwarming that unity must have felt. But his social conscience always just permeated his works. And I'll tell you, these are just love songs. There's not a deeper message here at all, except that we need to sing the works of Mark Blitzstein because they lay dormant for a long period of time. In the 1960s, early 60s, his wife had passed away and he felt that he could live much more openly. They had had a marriage of convenience and she knew very much that he was gay. And so after she died, I think he felt that he was able to live his life more freely. And sadly, it's very much a Matthew Shepard story. He was pulled out of a bar in Martinique and left in an alleyway to die that night. He was barely conscious the next day, but he was able to name his accusers, and they were arrested, which says something for Martinique. But anyway, his pieces lay dormant for decades because he had died so young that no one had paid attention to the rites, and so they just all kind of got put in a box. And right around 2000, his nephews were able to get the rights to his pieces and publish them. And so this is a set of three pieces from some of his. He really was a hybrid opera / musical theater, which was very appropriate in the 50s and 60s, if you think about the literature that was going on in the United States and certainly in New York. The final set of this, I'm so excited, it's very difficult to find duets for sopranos and tenors. And while we'll both take a turn at taking the low end, and we'll both struggle, I will struggle lots, but we'll find it. But I really wanted to sing The Bird Upon the Tree. And it's just this beautiful story of how a storm sometimes takes us to the other side, which I felt was very appropriate for these days upon us. So this is What Will It Be from his opera Regina.
What will it be? The one to say. Thank you.
our transition sort of from classical into a little musical theater, and we're just going to have a little fun with these last three pieces.
I met a man who had no humor.
and he kissed me right here, and he said, I'll give you stars and the moon and the dawn to guide you, and a promise I'll never go. I'll give you hope to bring out all the life inside you, and the strength that will help you grow. I'll give you truth and a future that's dwelling down from any Hollywood plot. And I thought, you know,
thank you.
Kirsten Magi, who will be singing soprano, along with pianist Leslie Bunch will be joining her as well. So we look forward to that recital. So thank you, God bless, and have a wonderful day.